By the end of this video, you'll know whether Webflow AI actually can build a quality website for you, and if this is the future of building with AI. Now, I have very limited knowledge with Webflow, so I'm going to try this and see if somebody coming into Webflow new would be able to use this. But if you also have experience using Webflow, then leave a comment and let us know what you think when it comes to what this comes up with. So I'm going to choose the AI site builder. And then as we go into this, this is what's going to happen. So we have the basics, start with the basics. Let's say a business, name of the business, we're going to call it Jack's SEO. I'm going to build an SEO design firm website. And there are different prompts here that you can use. This is good, a consultancy that builds apps and websites. So I'm just going to modify this and pause the video. Okay, so I've written out the prompt here. You can pause the video if you want to read it. But it's basically saying that we offer SEO services and three main services for that. And then it gets to step three of three, where you define your style. And what we're going to do is just stick with AI suggested for all of these and click generate. And then I'll let you know how long this takes. Okay, that took less than a minute. And take a look on your screen now, because this is the initial prompt or the initial design that it's come up with. And it actually has some dynamic elements in here too. And it's basically a very standard landing page style where it's going to sell people on the SEO services with buttons and different things. And we can see it's asking people to consult now to get started. And I could have been more specific as well in the prompt to talk about exactly what I wanted in here. But if you look on the left-hand side of the screen, you can also modify the theme, the colors, and different things as well. So I'm just going to do a quick one here. So if I click this one, it's changing the font and also the colors. I actually like the first one that it came up with, so we'll stick with that. And then you can go more into the specifics of the colors, which is really cool here. You can see there's a light and a dark mode. We can change the typography here. We can even change the settings too. So sections either start with an inverse variant or sprinkle in inverse sections to create a higher contrast look. I quite like the way it's done it there. Now the images, if you look on your screen, the images look very AI generated. You can tell by the text on the screen. And if we scroll down, yep, more of this. Obviously this is us, our team, in the office environment. So it's just very like generic in terms of, all right, it's actually got a blog post here too. Now we're going to look at in a moment, if we click start building, I think it's going to take us to the Webflow edit page, which a lot of people who have used Webflow will understand. In fact, let's do that now. So here we are. Now, from my basic understanding of Webflow, this is the design builder that you go into when you first start using Webflow. Now you can create something like this as well through templates on Webflow and using your own templates and designs. But if you are new to Webflow or if you want to get something done quickly, this could definitely be a great starting point for you. And what's interesting is what you're going to see is if we click this, yes, it's going to actually have the style in here. It's going to have the settings too. And because Webflow is very intuitive in terms of how to do it, you can just make these changes with the text by double-clicking on it. And I think this is what a lot of people want when it comes to AI builders, is the ability to build with AI, but not just rely on prompts when it comes to changing text, changing fonts, changing designs. And instead, you can go in here, double-click on anything, including an image, I imagine, and choose a different image as well. So I'm quite impressed with how it's done this. And what I'm going to just do a couple of things to check is to see what it looks like on mobile. So yep, it's definitely responsive here. We'll also look on tablet too. Yep, responsive. I mean, with this, you wouldn't want all of these images in this way here like this. But it's a good start anyway. And we go back to desktop. And then if we click on pages, what we have here is a home we have the style guide page, and then we have utility pages, password, and 404. So what's interesting is that once you have this, then you'll have to create a theme based on this, I imagine, to create different pages. And also, it does have a footer, and it has a navigation, one instance of it. Now, if we go into the CMS of this, no collections to edit. So it hasn't done anything yet. So you would have to go into and build a blog page. And we have tutorials on that on the YouTube channel and also on the course that we have at nocode.mba. You can take a look at that. There's a link in the description. And one thing to note, there might not be a way to use AI and use prompts after the fact once you've built it. If that is available, I can't see it anywhere on here. If it is available, let us know. But that might be a pain point for somebody who's just getting into Webflow. But if you're looking for something that combines AI with a very powerful and customizable tool like Webflow, then this could be a very good solution for a lot of people when it comes to building websites. So again, go check the link in the description to go to nocode.mba and take our full course on Webflow. If you want to stay on YouTube, then go to the playlist in the description too. And let us know your thoughts on this. So am I missing something when it comes to prompting after the fact? Have you used this website AI builder before? And what are your first impressions of this after this first build? Okay, thanks so much for watching, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.